Hello and welcome to one more English lesson. Yeah, as always, we're gonna move on today and we're gonna work on this new IELTS practicing. Okay, I mean IELTS, Cambridge examinations. Okay, like these are all about learning how to do, what is the name of that, proficiency examination. Okay, this is how we work, this is what we're gonna do. And today I'm gonna share an activity with you, okay? So please just follow me, pay attention on that, okay? I'm gonna share the screen with you, right? So listen carefully how I read the explanations of the words that I'm gonna read and the samples that I'm gonna use, okay? So please, let's do it together, okay? So please follow me. And again, yeah, this is gonna be the first official, live lesson, like following this new preparation, okay? So pay attention on that, because that is going to be very important for you, for everybody here. And this, the things that we're going to do here, it's like the intermediate to advanced level, okay? So this is not for basics, it's too much for basic students. So of course, for you to be here, you at least has to be intermediate level. So again, if you have any recommendation as we go over the lessons, like, teacher, could you talk about this? Can you give me some hints about that? Feel free to ask me that, okay? So let's check it out. Here, as you can see, yeah, let's move my head down below, okay? I'm gonna put myself here. I'm gonna make it a little bit closer. Okay, so maybe is it, I don't know, maybe you can see that in a better way. But anyway, follow me. And let me see. Yeah, I mean, reading. This is a reading section. If it's a reading section, it means that we're going to analyze a reading. Okay? And so pay attention on that. Section 1, questions 1 to 14. Read the text below and answer the questions 1 to 8. So we're going to read this question, okay? So is this part here, follow me. I'm gonna make it a little bit bigger, I believe. I don't know, let me see, tell me if it's gonna be better for you in this way. Okay, I think it's a little bit better, right? So give me just a second, let me put myself on over here. I'm gonna make myself a little bit smaller, right? So it's not a big deal. Okay, so the best travel wallets. Okay, so we're gonna read that and we're gonna see, we're gonna understand what kind of text, what kind of reading is it. Okay, so just follow me. Keep all your bank cards, documents, passports, and ID in one of these convenient carriers, which have been selected by Becca Meyer. Okay, so the best travel wallets, keep all your bank cards, documents. So probably this is going to be something about wallets. And then we have A. We have this first one here. Can you see that, guys? So let's read that. On Kipling Travel Doc, travel document holder. So probably this is the name of the product, okay? This zip-around wallet, the name of the wallet, comes in 5 different patterns and is made of nylon. It also has a space where users can put a pen, pockets for cards, and ID window, and a pocket for change. So we have some important words here, like ID, and what else? Pockets for cards, pocket for change, and all that. So I believe you know what is pocket, right? So for now, that is the first part. Okay, so just gonna make some little information here, okay? So just pay attention, yeah? Like on words like ID window, on words that maybe you don't know, right? Okay, so nylon. So just keep your eyes over that, and I mean, don't forget, right? Okay, so anyway, let's move on. Going to letter B, we have the second part. Life Adventure Mini Travel Document Wallet. So of course, this probably is about the second, not probably, but I mean, this is about the second wallet, right? That's why the best travel wallets. This is the topic of the, of the reading. And here we have names of possible different kinds of wallets that you can use for traveling, okay? And of course, we are talking about here brands, as it seems. So let's check it out a little bit about this B part. This is a waterproof wallet which uses anti-RFID radio frequency identification material, so your financial details will be safe. And it is black with smart sky blue finishing touches and has a small internal compartment, a smartphone pocket, and an external pocket. Each can fit two passports. Amazing, right? So what is the word that we have to keep in mind here? Which uses, so this is a waterproof wallet, which uses this RFID, which is radio frequency identification material. So your financial details will be safe. So it's, there is a kind of a technological system, yeah, that helps somehow to keep that, I mean, protected, right? And again, we have some descriptions here about the colors. It is black with smart sky blue finishing touches and has a small internal compartment. So you see, an external pocket. You can fit, another important point here, two passports. You can fit to me. Is it possible for you to put two passports at the same time? You know, there is enough space for that. So this is the definition of this letter B. Letter C. Kef Kidston Breton Stripe. Kef Kidston Breton Stripe. A wallet so slim. Good word here. A wallet so slim, it could easily pass for a small notebook. The inside compartment labels identifying each separate section all have silver lettering on them. The wallet has a special coating which makes it easy to wipe anything like sand off. You see? And I think that's very interesting, right? That's very, very interesting. Let me get this one here. Okay, no. So take a look on that. What informations we have? The first one, a wallet is so slim it could easily pass for, I mean, a small notebook. So people can think, oh, this is not a pen, but I mean, this is not a wallet, but this is like a notebook. Okay, so this is the point here. The inside compartment labels identifying each separate section all have silver lettering on them. So if it has labels, which means that there is something that you can identify, like maybe, I don't know, maybe a letter, like here, all have a silver lettering on them. Silver lettering. Do you know what is that silver lettering? So, I mean, is it, sometimes when we think about a wallet, like this is a wallet, right? You know, I guess, right? This is an old wallet, actually, okay? So when I say that inside we have labels, like we have here in the reading, right? The inside compartment, which is inside of the wallet, labels identifying each separate section all have silver lettering on them. Imagine like inside like this, okay, we have this. Imagine that we have like letters, you know, like, I don't know, maybe A, B, C. Imagine something like that in silver color. This is the meaning when I say that inside your wallet, yeah, has labels separating each section. So section one, suppose this one doesn't have, right? This is my old wallet, okay? It doesn't have anything separating here, but supposing that I had, so it would be like section A, B, C, D, and silver lettering means that the letters, the symbols, yeah, that are here, they are in silver color. That is the meaning, right? So, I hope you have understood that. Coming back. Okay. And again, continuing the water on them, and the wallet has a special coating, which makes it easy to wipe anything like sand off. When I say that, I mean the material, right? It's a special material that when you want to clean it out, when you want to wipe the dirty from inside, so it's easy. Example, like, I don't know, maybe you go to the beach and then you put your wallet on the table at the beach or something like that. And as we, everybody knows, yeah, like, if we have a wind or anything related to that, I mean, we know that sand will come into the wallet. So sometimes it's a little bit complicated to clean it up, right? To wipe the sand out. So, wipe off this one, right? So this is letter C, okay? This is the information that we have about this option C, about this one here. Let's go to D. Ted Baker. Voyagers travel, yeah, voyagers. Sorry, I'm gonna put this pronunciation because this is not an easy, okay? Ted Baker voyagers travel wallet. So voyager. So listen to the British pronunciation of these words, guys. Listen to that. Let's see. 1, 2, 3.
Voyager.
Yeah, voyager. It's was not wrong, actually. So, Ted Baker Voyager's travel wallet. This wallet comes in smooth black leather. The material, remember, the material, leather is a material. And is no bigger than a passport. But roomy, okay, enough for any insurance documents of flight tickets. A small navy blue pen is supplied inside. Okay, so again, every time that we are reading something, the first thing that we do, we go directly to the words that we don't know. Okay, but take a look on this word here. Okay, so I'm gonna correct the pronunciation. Okay, the pronunciation of this word room is like this.
Roomy.
Roomy. Roomy. Okay. Let me see here. I'm gonna make a note. Yeah, I'm gonna add a new note. So just for you guys to see. So this word equals pronunciation roomy. Okay, like that. I don't know if you can see that here in this. I'm gonna get a little bit closer. Let me see if I can. Do you want to save and pin your created note here? Yes, I'm gonna save it. Okay. So you see? So this is, let me see if I can get it. Yeah, I can get it closer, but I think you can, right? So I'm gonna put this note here. Okay, so when I click over that, pronunciation roomy. Okay? So let's get back. Okay, moving on. Roomy enough for any insurance documents or flight tickets. A small navy blue pen is supplied inside. Navy blue is the description of the color, okay? So, and then this word, roomy. Teacher, what is roomy? When I say that my wallet is roomy enough for documents, what I mean with that is that it's large enough and can provide you with enough space for what you want. Roomy means it has room, it has space for that, okay? In that case here, it has space for any insurance document or flight tickets. Insurance, do you know what is insurance? Okay, I hope so, right? If you don't, check it out. That again, if you don't know, still ask me, okay? And a small navy blue pen is supplied inside. The supply, I mean, if you buy that, okay, it's supplied to me. There is a pen inside of the wallet, okay? It comes together. When you buy the wallet, you get the pen, okay? So that is the letter D. Let's go for the letter E, right? So E. Radley Abbey Travel Wallet. Remember that these names, these black names that I read, they are the names of the wallet, okay? They are the brand, okay? So like Nike wallet, the Radley Abbey Travel Wallet, just the names of the brand, okay? And but all of them are wallets. And so this plain, which means simple, yeah, travel wallet opens up to reveal pockets in various colors, labeled cards, passport, and tickets, as well as others left blank for extras. It comes in a handy drawstring bag. Handy drawstring bag. So let's go on. I'm going to explain you some words here. The first one, we have plain, which is simple. It's not like so, I don't know, exquisite, something, wow, super amazing, very, no, it's a simple one, okay? And when you open it up, it reveals, I mean, you can see inside, that is the meaning here, yeah? It has various colors, labeled cards. I mean, again, you get your wallet, and when you see inside of your wallet, you're going to see like some cards labeled, like in this area, you can put this, in that area, you can put that, yeah, like, the area for cards, the areas for passport and for tickets. So you see, so your wallet, when you open that, it's going to be there already, okay, like where you should put any document. So something very interesting, right? As well as, this is a way to show like also, as well as it works pretty much like also, okay? So it should do this, and also that. So it should do... It does actually, sorry, yeah, it does each, and as well as another thing, okay? So this is how we work on as well as, okay? Sorry, my head here is in front of, let me put it down below, okay? So now I think you can see that, without my head in front of that, okay? So, as well as others left blank for extra, it comes in a handy drawstring bag. So, let's go. Let's analyze here something handy and drawstring. Okay, so just to give you explanation, when we say that something is handy, like a bag, for example, we say that it's practical. You can have it on your hand, you know, like you can grab it and you can put it in your pocket easily. And when we say that, for example, a wallet or a bag had this string, yeah, like this thing. So I think, I don't know, maybe you know that a string is like, it's like a thin rope, right? That we put you, and it helps you. For example, you put a bag on your shoulder, and then there, what keeps here over your shoulder is a string. So if we have like a wallet like that, this is what I mean. Check it out. I'm gonna show you a picture of that. Can you see? This is an example. As you can see here, like there is like a string, okay? Can you see that? So this is what we call drawstring, okay? This is the definition of drawstring, okay? I think it's not so complicated to understand, right? So yeah, that is the definition of the word drawstring. So let's get back to the reading now, okay? So I'm going to get back here and let's continue our reading. Okay, so let's move my head to up here, right? And let's go to the letter F, right? As you can see. Okay, so as we have here on this letter F, Go Travel Organizer. So the name of this wallet is Go Travel Organizer, okay? So let's see what we have here. The black wallet features 7 slip-in card compartments, 2 small interior zip pockets, and a load of other slip-in compartments. It can fit at least 4 passports. At least, I mean, at minimum, yeah? Which means that probably each can fit more than 4, probably, but I mean, at minimum 4, for sure, you can have inside of this pocket. I think the name is very interesting, Go Travel Organizer, right? And moving on. Again, we have some descriptions of the color. The black wallet features 7 slip-in cards. And I mean, what else we have here? Sleep in card compartments. Do you know what is sleep in? Do you understand that definition? Okay, so if you're sleeping, it means that you can put inside, you can sleep. You can, yeah, you put that and then you put inside. That is the point. And let's go to the next one, which is D. And this is the last. Go travel glow travel wallet. Go travel glow travel wallet. So this is a simple, very reasonably priced wallet. Reasonably, we have an, I think, let me see the definition of this word. Okay, so number one, reasonably is an adverb. Okay, remember the definition of adverb? Change the degree of the verb of the action, right? So very reasonably priced means it's a good price. Okay, it's an okay price. It is made of PVC and plastic, and will suit those. Will be good for, yeah. Will be a good choice for those who like a wallet that is easy to spot. Do you understand that definition? Spot. Spot is when it's easy to find. So, for example, what kind of problems we have when we don't have a spotty object? For example, keys. Keys that we use, like car keys, house keys, it's really easy to lose it, right? I mean, when you lose, when you, for example, my keys are lost, right? Example, they just disappeared inside of my house. I don't know where they are because they are small. I mean, not easy to see. Okay, they are not easy to spot. So that's the definition of spot. It comes in a range of bright colors. So we have a definition for colors with a white holiday-related design. So it's the design of the wallet is like a holiday design. Yeah, so probably for traveling people, for travel, yeah, for people who likes to travel. And on the front, in the front of the wallet, it has five compartments that can fit a passport with other cards and tickets. So just descriptions of what kind of things we can put inside of the wallet. Okay, so I mean, pretty much these are the, I mean, are the descriptions, yeah, of the wallets, of the options of wallets that we can get, yeah, we can buy. I mean, in this first part of the writing. So we have made a really deep analyzing it into the vocabulary, and I think it is really really clear for you guys, right? Then, okay, so let's make it a little bit bigger, right? Let's make it a little bit bigger. Okay, so just a second. Okay, like that. Okay, so these are all the samples, all the examples that we have here, right? So section one, questions 1 to 14. So we again, the topic is the best travel wallets. And then the headline here, yeah, the subheading, keep all your bank cards, document, passports, and ID in one of these convenient carriers, which have been selected by Beckermeyer. Yeah, Beckermeyer. So Kipling Travel. So basically here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 different wallets, yeah. And each of them has its definition, its description, yeah, and its feature. So, all right. So we got that. Very good. Let's go to the next page. And we have the questions in the next page. So let's see that. Okay, so as you can see here, right? Let me get a little bit. Oh, sorry. Okay. So I think it's possible to see, right? Questions 1 to 8. Look at the 7 reviews of travel wallets A to G. Which one is that, teacher? The ones that we have just read. And for which travel wallet are the following statements true? Write the correct letter A to D in boxes 1 to 8 on your answer sheet. So basically here, we're gonna have like descriptions, yeah, informations, and each information will be connected to one of the descriptions, one of the wallets that we have read. Okay, so your goal here is to discover which one is connected to each one. Okay, so I mean, I'm gonna get closer, okay? So, and then later when we were analyzing, so we can see the two pages, okay? But sorry, I'm gonna get closer right now, so just follow me. On and B, you may use any letter more than once. Check it out that. You may use any letter more than once. So maybe we're gonna have descriptions that suits for more than one. Okay, so let's see. Number one, this wallet will suit people who prefer natural materials. This wallet will suit people who prefer natural materials. Number two, users of this wallet do not need to worry about taking it out in the rain. Number three, parts of the inside of this wallet have categories printed on them in one color. This wallet would suit someone who needs to keep several passports together. Do you know several? Many passports together, right? So again, even when we are reading I mean, it's important to check it out, like to make sure that you understand the words. On next one. Something is provided for writing. Something is provided for writing. This number five, I think, is the easiest one, this one. Okay? On six, this will suit people who want to be able to find their document wallet easily in their luggage. Again, this will be good for people who want to be able to find their document wallet easily in their luggage. Number seven, something to keep this wallet in is provided. Something to keep this wallet in is provided. And this wallet has been specially made to prevent people detecting the numbers on any bank cards, etc., inside it. Okay, so we have had that, right? We have read that. So now I'm gonna now what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna change the camera view. Okay, I'm gonna put like the two pages together. So I'm gonna do some of the examples. Yeah, I'm gonna do some of the exercises, and of course the rest, the ones that I don't finish, that's gonna be homework for you. Pretty much this. Okay, so give me just a second. All right. So let me see if I can put it in a good way here. Okay. So let's go. Tell me if you can see that. Okay, so the sentences, they are above me, yeah, like, and let me see if I can get it a little bit closer here. Yeah, I mean, not too good, but I think it's possible to see, right? So we can see all the options and we can see all the questions as well. So let's do this. Okay, so the first thing when we are doing this kind of exercise, yeah, is we're gonna practice the speed, yeah, as fast you hit you read, as fast you understand, faster, I mean, you're gonna get that, yeah. So do this as fast as possible. This is my recommendation to you. Not now, not in the beginning, like now we are just practicing, but as more you practice, I mean, better you get. This is obvious, right? More you practice, better you get. So let's see. Number five, let's begin for for the one that in my opinion is the easiest. Something is provided for writing. So let's read this first option here, right? Let's read this first sample. On Kipling travel document holder. This zip around wallet comes in five different patterns and is made of nylon. It also has a space where users can put a pen, pockets for cards, an ID window, and a pocket for change. I mean, it says something that you can put a pen, but doesn't say anything that has a pen inside of it. So if you can put it, it means that you can put only that. It doesn't mean that you're gonna get one for you to use, like as a present. So something is provided for writing? No, nothing is provided in the option A. B, life venture mini travel. Yeah, This is a waterproof wallet which uses an anti-RFID radio frequency identification material, so your financial details will be safe. It is black with smart sky blue finishing touch and has a small internal compartment, a smartphone pocket, and an external pocket. Each can fit two passports. Again, has this radio frequency identification, has some kind of technology, but I mean, we don't use that for writing, right? So, and there is no other information about something inside of that that we can use for writing. So, no. A wallet, so, letter C, CAF's Keystone Breton Stripe. A wallet so slim it could easily pass for a small notebook. The inside compartment labels identifying each separate section all have silver lettering on them. The wallet has a special coating which makes it easy to wipe anything like sand off. Okay, we have some descriptions of the inside compartment. We have some labels and they are in silver color. But I mean, nothing saying that there is something there that we can use to write. So D, Ted Baker, right? So this wallet comes in smooth black leather and is no bigger than a passport, but roomy enough for any insurance documents or flight tickets. A small navy blue pen is supplied inside. Oh, I think I got it, right? A small navy blue pen. Okay, so navy blue pen means the color is blue. When we say is supplied in the past, it means that it is there. You're gonna get that as part of the product. Okay, so there is a pen inside, so we can use for write. So, in my opinion, D is a very good it's a very good option for this one, right? So maybe, I don't know. In my opinion, D is a good one, right? So, I don't know. Give me your reason. So D, if I could say, I would say that here it's the option D. Okay, so of course it is option D. Yeah, but just practicing, just for sure, just to make sure that we didn't make mistakes. I'm gonna read the rest. E, Radley Abbey Travel Wallet. So this plain travel wallet opens up to reveal pockets in various colors, labeled cards, passports, and tickets, as well as others left blank for extras. It comes in a handy drawstring bag. Again, there is nothing here saying that there is something that we can use for to write. F, Go Travel Organizer. The black wallet features 7 sleeping cards compartments, and 2 small interior zip pockets, and a load of other sleeping in compartments. It can fit at least 4 passports. Again, no comments about that. Go Travel Wallet. This is a simple, very reasonably priced wallet. It is made of PVC. If you don't know what's PVC, I recommend you to check it out. It's a product. It's the name of a product only. Again, it has nothing to do with pen or pencils. Don't worry. And will suit those who like a wallet that is easy to spot. It comes in a range of bright colors with a white holiday-related design on the front. It has 5 compartments that can fit your passport with other cards you get. So, yeah, as we could see, the only one that has an information saying that, okay, there is something there is the option D. So something is provided for writing D. So this is what we have to do. We have to connect the options to the numbers, to the options here in this part. Okay, again, you may use any letter more than once. Maybe you're going to repeat, like maybe for option 1 and 6, that's going to be C, you know, it might happen, it can happen. So your homework is to do that for me, okay? Answer this, read carefully, answer that, and send me all the answers, okay? What do you have to do? Pay attention. Number 1, answer, put the answers on your notebook, take a picture and send me. That's number 1. Number 2, I want you to read this, the best travel wallets in English. I want you to read all the description. You don't need to read the questions, only the description. Read the description in English 1 time, send me the audio. Read the 2nd time in Portuguese, send me the audio. This is all you have to do. Answer, write, send me the picture, and read one time in English, one time in Portuguese. That's it. Right, so this is the beginning of our proficiency examination preparation course, okay? So focus on that. Okay, just focus on, don't worry too much on how are you gonna do that. Just do what I'm telling you. And of course, let's work hard on that, because this is the top of the top, okay? So if you have any questions, leave on the comments below or just send me a message, okay? And then I see you next time, guys. Only that, simple like this. Bye-bye, take care.